Hi there, and thank you for joining us here on the web. Calling hours are being held today for a fallen Navy SEAL from New Hampshire. The body of William Blake Marston arrived back in the Granite State last night. The 31-year-old died last week in a parachute training accident in Florida. Calling hours will be held from 3 to 7 at the Bennett Funeral Home in Concord. A celebration of Marston's life will be held at 10:30 tomorrow morning at the Bedford Presbyterian Church. Activists staged a peaceful demonstration in Exeter last night to promote the message that Black Lives Matter. Occupy New Hampshire Seacoast held the vigil on the steps of the Exeter Town Hall. They say that they want to hold members of the justice system responsible for the recent deaths of unarmed black men and end abuse against people of color. Yesterday morning, dozens of people linked arms and stopped traffic on 93 outside of Boston with the same message in mind. Some of the protesters in Exeter say sometimes extreme measures are necessary.
I think if we're going to change society, people have to take some risks and do some things that seem a little outlandish, because the truth is the way our society is set up right now is a little outlandish.
In Massachusetts, state police say they arrested 29 people in connection with the protests that brought the morning commute to a halt. Police officers around the state may soon be able to administer the drug Narcan to people who are overdosing on heroin. Right now, only EMTs are allowed to administer the drug. Narcan can reverse the effects of an overdose and restart a person's breathing. The new rules being proposed would allow for local police officers to decide whether they want to be trained in administering this drug. Governor Maggie Hassan says this is one way to fight back against a spike in heroin use.
What these new rules allow is for local law enforcement to choose whether they want to get the certification so that they too could administer Narcan. In the event that they're a first responder to an overdose, they could really save lives.
The proposed rule will go into effect for 180 days until a legislative committee decides whether or not to make it permanent. Farmington police have arrested the man they say stole money from a woman at an ATM, and they say he may be responsible for a similar robbery in Wolfboro. Police say 28-year-old Alejandro De La Pena spoke to the woman at the drive-up ATM on Wednesday and then grabbed the money when it came out. Police found him passed out later in a car in a parking lot. A group of puppies and kittens that are in need of homes arrived at the Laconia Municipal Airport yesterday. The New Hampshire Humane Society partnered with a group called Operation Pets Alive to help save the animals from overcrowded shelters in the South. For more information, you can check out our website. And that's it for your morning webcast. Thanks for joining us. We'll be back on the air with more news and weather today at noon.